These images were generated using the Flux model. This model is better than other image generators, such as Stable Diffusion and Midjourney. However, Flux is well known for its incredible text-generating abilities. In this video, I will show you how to set up and run all Flux models within comfyui, without the need of installing Flux models or creating a workflow, as I have provided workflow links for all of the models in the video description. Welcome to AI Upskill. Let's get into the video. We will use Mimic PC, an AI tool that supports almost all Stable Diffusion apps, including Flux. So go to the tool from the link provided in the video's description. Once you've signed in and redirected to this dashboard, navigate to comfyui and click Get Started. From here, you can choose hardware with various VRAM and RAM sizes. Lastly, click Create and Start. Loading will begin immediately. When it is finished, you will see the comfyui workflow. This is a node, and all of these nodes are known as a workflow. To run Flux, we need a separate workflow. So click here to stop this app, and from the video's description, click on the link to the basic Flux workflow. You will be redirected to this page. To import this workflow, simply click the Apply button. Choose a hardware settings based on your needs from available VRAM and RAM sizes. Finally, select Create and Start. Let us skip the loading process, and as you can see, our Flux Dev workflow has been successfully imported. Let's use this workflow to generate an image. It already has the perfect settings applied. However, you can change the settings as per your needs. Simply enter your positive and negative prompts into the following boxes, and click the Cue prompt to start creating your image. Because it is an FP16 clip, the generation process will take quite a long time. Therefore, let us skip the generation process. Look, our image has been generated. As you can see, Flux did a fantastic job with both the model and the text. To generate an image with FP8 clip, simply change the weight type to FP8ED4M and the clip name to T5XLFP8. Let us now generate an image using the Schnell model. Simply change the UNet name to Flux Schnell, and the Flux Schnell workflow is ready. I won't change any further settings, as it already has the best settings applied, so simply enter your positive and negative prompts in the following boxes. Click the Cue prompt to start creating your image. The image will be generated quickly, as it is a Schnell model with FP8 clip. And as you can see, Schnell generates an image quickly, but the results are very different from the Flux Dev model. Let us now generate an image using the NF4 model. This model requires a different workflow, so in the video's description, click the link to the NF4 workflow. You will be redirected to this page. To import this workflow, simply click the Apply button. Choose a hardware settings based on your needs from available VRAM and RAM sizes. Finally, select Create and Start. Let us skip the loading process, and as you can see, our Flux NF4 workflow has been successfully imported. Let's use this workflow to generate an image. It already has the optimal settings applied. I will just change the width and height to 1024 pixels. However, you can change such settings on your own. Now, simply enter your positive and negative prompts into the following boxes. Click the Cue prompt to start creating your image. Let us skip the generation process. And see, our image has been generated. As you can see, it generates images quickly. The NF4 model generates images similar to the Flux Dev model, even in less time. Let us now create an image using the GGUF model. This model requires an entirely different workflow, so from the video's description, click the link to the GGUF workflow. You will be redirected to this page. To import this workflow, simply click the Apply button. Choose a hardware settings based on your needs from available VRAM and RAM sizes. Lastly, click Create and Start. Let us skip the loading process. And as you can see, the GGUF model workflow has been successfully imported. Let's use this workflow to generate an image. It already has the optimal settings applied. I will just change the width and height to 1024 pixels. However, you can change these settings on your own. Now, simply enter your positive and negative prompts into the following boxes. Click the Cue prompt to start creating your image. Let us skip the generation process. And see, our image has been generated. It generates an image with the same pose and styling as the NF4 model. However, it lacks the ability to properly represent text. Now that we've seen how to generate images with all Flux models, let's talk about which Flux model is appropriate for your specific needs. Here's a direct comparison of the models. The Dev model is for more detailed images, but it requires more time and memory to generate. Schnell uses less memory and time but generates unrealistic images. For faster results, NF4 and GGUF are the best choices. They generate images similar to the Dev model, but with slightly less detail. refer to this table to choose a model that meets your needs. That wraps up our tutorial on how to use Flux models without installing or creating their workflows. We've covered importing the basic Flux workflow generating images with all those models. This model is very powerful and popular. If you make something cool using these tools, please share it to the world and make sure you tag me. If you loved this video, please give it a like and subscribe AI Upskill channel for more such AI-related content in the upcoming days.